One of the comments I got on my YouTube channel was asking, what skills do you need to become a freelance or contracting data analyst? If you're new to my channel, my name is Shorful, and on this channel, we discuss all things data. So if you're a budding data analyst or even a seasoned pro or someone who just has an interest in data, please be sure to subscribe to my channel and also ring the bell icon so you stay up to date with all the helpful tips and advice I have to offer. Now, the thing about going as a freelance data analyst and the skills that you need, it does actually depend on what area you want to focus at. Now, generally, the area that I think data analysts are best positioned for is reporting requirements, okay? Now, what this normally means is that if you are looking to become a reporting analyst, then specialize in the, looking to become a freelance data analyst, then specialize in the reporting element of it, okay? And in that component, that is really much about building reports and delivering them to the business. Because what normally happens is that the business may have gone on some kind of transformation, they may have unified their data, they identified that they've got all these use cases. And part of those use cases is delivering reports to the business. Now, what happens in that short frame where they need to build reports? A, their analysts haven't got the skill set, or they haven't got the right type of analyst, or B, they just don't have the capacity. And so they want to bring someone in to help them build those reports. So if you want to become a freelance data analyst, that's an area that I would advise you to focus on. Now, the skills you need for that area is primarily Excel, SQL, and some kind of reporting visualization skill set. Now, if you know one of those tools, whether it's Power BI, Tableau, Click, Looker Studio, then if you know one of those, you'll be able to work out how the others work, okay? But generally, that's the sort of three components that you need. Now, the reason I mention Excel is that there'll be a lot of reporting requirements where you just have to build it in Excel and get it out the door, okay? But generally, it will be SQL and a visualization tool like Power BI or Tableau. So if you want to become a freelance data analyst, they're sort of the core that you'll find that people have a requirement for. Now, the other area that you'll find people have a requirement for are sort of the ad hoc analysis type skill sets. And in that area, you're really focusing on here Excel and SQL, okay? And the reason for that is because these are ad hoc. These are one-off queries that they want to know, and you're not really going to be repeating them time and time again, so you don't need to build them into a reporting tool. And generally, the teams that will have those kind of requirements are things like marketing or product, because what normally happens is that they do something, they do a campaign if they're a marketing, or they launch a product if they're the product team, and they just want to know how it performed, okay? So what you need to do is be able to go in, analyze that data, and help them understand how it performed. So that's the raw technical skills, the SQL and the Excel skills. And like I said, if you're going into the reporting element, some kind of visualization skill. The other skill that's quite fundamental that you understand is the sector that you're going into. Now, generally, I found that if you're a good analyst, you're able to pick up any sector because you know what you're looking for. So, for example, most sectors, you will be looking at things like when you talk about performance, you're looking at revenue, you're looking at number of customers, you're looking at transactions. You know generally what you're looking at. But again, try to make sure that the sectors you go in, you understand the data and the kind of data that you will have access to. And the second component of that softer side, rather than the technical skill, is being able to discern what the question is. Now, this is really key if you're becoming a freelancer, because you don't have the luxury of wasting time. A lot of the time people bring you in as a freelancer is because you can get things going very quickly, okay? So what I would advise is that you understand how to ask questions to get to the root of the problem very quickly, and then replay back the need, the question, and say to your stakeholder, you know, from what I've understood, this I believe what you need. Now, what happens is that if you're able to articulate that question, articulate their question in a way that both they understand it and you understand it, when you go off and do the analysis, you'll be able to get it right pretty much the first time. That then minimizes the amount of time wasted of going backward and forward saying, oh, I didn't want that. Actually, can you change this? Oh, I meant this, whereas you've delivered this. You bypass all of that, because as a freelance data analyst, the reason they hire you is because they want you to be up and running quickly and also to be an expert. So you should know what you're doing. So like I said, in order to get into freelance data analyst, the first step is to choose where you're going to focus on, whether the reporting side. If you do the reporting side, you will have to pick up a visualization tool. But if you go into the ad hoc analysis side, which, you know, in my experience, I've seen not much of compared to the reporting side, but it is still a big area. There's lots of work still required being asked of analysts in that space, especially in the freelance contract space, especially with marketing teams, actually. Marketing teams have this sort of very tactical need for analysis, and so that's why they bring in freelancers, because they just have a period of time where they need this analysis. The current team doesn't have the capacity to meet that short-term need, or they don't have the expertise to deal with that data. So you know, like I said, SQL, Excel is really good for that area, and then secondly, learn those softer skills, one around being able to articulate the problem, and also around the sector, the industry, so you understand what the problem is. Now, finally, when you are going into freelancing as a data analyst, the thing I would recommend is speak to some recruiters or look on job posts for contracting roles and see what is being asked of in demand as a tool. Because normally what you do, you get selected based on your skills of using a particular tool or actually a particular technique. So they might ask, can you, you know, if it's about building reports in Tableau, they'll ask, do you have skills in Tableau? However, on the marketing side, it might be, do you have experience of analyzing campaign effectiveness, or do you have experience of evaluating the effectiveness of loyalty programs? Whatever it is, you know, you need to make sure that you have that expertise, and make sure you put it at the top of your CV so that when it's scanned, those are the things that are picked up. And don't forget, you've got to reflect the keywords that the client is asking for. A lot of the time, CVs are filtered, unless it's a very senior role. Most roles, they're filtered by automated screening systems. So therefore, you need to make sure CV contains those keywords. So it's a bit like doing SEO for your CV. So do a bit of research in that. Therefore, you're more likely to have a chance of being selected. Ideally, if you can make personal relationships with recruiters in the contracting space, then you're more likely to get your CV in front of clients than not. But again, it depends. If you do your research well, you can get those roles directly. And once you're in, then you'll find that being a freelance data analyst, you'll find other projects because now you're known. But it is key that you have those core skills. If you don't have Excel, SQL for the majority of the cases, it's going to be very hard to become a data analyst. And then, like I said, for the reporting component of it, you do need that visualization tool. There will be other skill sets that they will be looking for. There'll be skills like, do you know Python? Do you know digital analytics? There'll be particular tools like Hotjar, where they're looking for to understand customer experience on the website. There may be particular technology that they want you to be familiar with. For example, they might want to know that if you're familiar with MongoDB, or if you're familiar with a BigQuery. But again, they're case by case. Again, like I said, the majority of what I see skills required for freelance data analysts fit within the three core skills that I've talked about. Those other skills are peripheral, but there's like need for them as well. So if you can learn and pick some of those skills up, that's really good. Now, the other thing to sort of mention is how much experience should you have in those skills? Now, to go freelance, I would really recommend that you have at least a 2 years experience. 1 year, you know, you can just about get away with it, but I think 2 years will give you enough confidence and have enough practice in those tools and the skills to be able to demonstrate value to clients very quickly. Okay, thank you for watching the video. I hope you found it useful. Please do like and share the video, and of course please subscribe to my channel and ring that bell icon so you don't miss any future videos that I'll be creating. Thank you.